just a smile?
Yeah, why not?
I don't know the full, I mean, please correct me, gentlemen, but these gentlemen all went into the RAF as boys. They were boy entrants.
So, that field there is called Pole Field, because in the war, any field that was longer than certain yardage. Yeah.
Started quarter past, so we'll start a little bit early. But there are still quite a few empty chairs, especially on the front row.
Yes, again. Okay, good afternoon, gentlemen, and welcome to the 20th annual general meeting of the Royal Air Force Appointments Association. On behalf of the committee, I'd like to thank you for your attendance today. I would also like to thank you personally for giving me the opportunity to serve as the Association Secretary over the last year. Thank you very much for that. Now, one or two admin points. Right? First of all, mobile phones. Can you please turn your mobile phones off or put them on silent? Possibly. Mention a more serious matter, and one which I'm sure you are all aware of. The last year has been very difficult for the Association for the continued serious illness affecting our webmaster, John Ward, and the resignations of Adrian Trowbridge from the Membership Secretary's role in January 2013 due to other commitments, and Chris Baker from his merchandising and arboretum liaison role through illness in July. Fortunately, we have managed to find replacements for both these, and this will become apparent when we reach the item dealing with the election of office bearers. The most serious of the issues we have had to face is John Ward's illness, which has made a huge dent in the Association's ability to function properly and brought home to the committee how much the Association as a whole is dependent on that website. Due to John's watertight security system, plus the fact that we are now using an American hosting company, GoDaddy, nobody but John can access the website, either to update it, publish information, or manage the PayPal account, all of which are essential to the smooth running of the Association. Now, unfortunately, with John Hobbs hospitalised and separated from his PC equipment, he is unable to resolve any of these issues. Now, we have now managed, with John's help, to resolve the PayPal account issue by opening a new PayPal account linked directly to the Association's bank account under control of the Treasurer. But that PayPal account is not yet linked to the website, okay? Yeah. And we're working with John to provide a solution to security access issues without compromising the site's data protection. Now, there has been quite a bit of adverse comment aimed at both the website and the committee over the ongoing situation, all of which are misdirected and stem from a complete misunderstanding of how the website is constructed. There was no easy fix, regardless of what some self-styled experts would have you believe. Right? We have a big problem with our website. As a result of the foregoing, it has become abundantly clear that we have no support in depth within the Association. We have no disaster recovery or succession planning. Should a similar thing happen again, we will be really deeply in it. It would be very helpful to have a pool of available members who would be prepared to pick up the baton at short notice. Now, I know we have in the past asked for volunteers, and we haven't managed to find them, but we do seriously ask again if anybody can find it in their hearts to volunteer to serve on the committee on whatever function, we'd be more than grateful to have your names. However, notwithstanding the above, the committee has come to the following conclusions as a result of John Ward's continued illness. The existing website has been developed by John, using a system called Dreamweaver, and making extensive use of HTML, a website programming language which only John knows intimately out of all the people on the committee. The structure of the site, how it links together, and how it operates on a day-to-day basis is known only to John, because he actually built it. Unfortunately, none of the present committee, other than Tom Brown, has a technical expertise, and none of us have the time or space available to take it on as it stands, even if that was possible. As the association owns the data and the content, but not the hardware or the programming, because John's PCs are John's equipment, and John constructed the programs, so they are actually his. Right? The data is ours, but the system is his.
Does it work? Yes.
Yeah,
well, you see, because that was the 41st entry, not the 51st, I could work out that you could stick that on your tongue. You're not listening, Graham, are you?
Not listening.
You can stick it on your tie, it works. Sod off.
Gentlemen, I didn't actually ask for a show of hands on the AGM. I thought the minutes would like a show of hands.
Slight oversight.
Is this chap just walked in with the meat packers?
Throw that bum out.
Right, well, good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon.
You see who I am? Sorry, I'm a Harriford boy, but don't hold it against me. Okay, I'm going to zip through the first part, and then I'm going to go on to what I would normally do later on in the at the AGM, and then it's all done, my bit out of the way.
You're pissed,
isn't it? Yeah. Right, okay, hopefully everybody found their block all right and was bedded where they wanted to be. Yeah, a lot of requests came in. This afternoon morning, we had the activities this morning. I must point out to you that a number of forms I had back, they got nothing on it at all apart from the name and address. So if you're a vegetarian and you didn't tick it, I'm sorry, you're going to eat meat. Right? No, you're not really. All I ask is that when these reservation forms come out, please tick the boxes. Yeah, so I know exactly what you want or what you don't want. The activities, a lot of people left them blank, which, fine, okay, I take it you don't want to do an activity. Requested to be sat with somebody at somebody's table, I have done my utmost to put you there. The tables this year, there's some tables of 5, there's some tables of 10, there's some of 6 and 7, so I've done my best to seat you where you want, yeah? If you're not, I'm sorry, my cocker. But hopefully you're all where you want to be.
No, you can't do everything.
That's true. Right. Okay, we're meeting reception. You've all got to have this tie, gentlemen, this evening. This is the social tie, right?
Well, no, we're not.
I leave it with you. I'm not president. He's in charge. Right, okay. Graham's told you about the toast and what have you, so then we'll march in the banner and away we go. Right, all tables have got wine on, we'll have wine, and it is basically half a bottle of wine each. So if you drink wine, that's fine. If you don't, the other guys on your table, okay. The bar will be open if you want something different, but there's squash and water as well.
100% audit conducted by our auditor. Who's a good friend of mine, Bill. 39th entry of Clark Caps by the name of Dave Kemp. And I'll just give you a couple of seconds there to read through his report, and then I'll just quickly run through the figures with you.
That's before Jim Oakley entered.
Which one do you?
Right, membership 2013. Right. For those who've never met me before, you've probably heard from me by email or by phone. I've certainly got on your nerves a bit in the last 5 months. My name is Morgan Brown. 46th entry, RAF Cosford. And wireless. or electronic communications, as we were later known. And then I transferred to flight simulators. I've served 24 years, and my responsibilities. Well, I've succeeded, I believe, Roy Gooden, Adrian Trowbridge, and there was a temporary secretary, Ozzy, did take on the role for a while. I was co-opted this year in April 2013, so as yet I'm not properly a full member of your committee. And I hold a master spreadsheet which contains all of the members' details. So what I've done is I've modified an Excel spreadsheet and I've got everybody's details, their entry, their address, etc. I've got the country where they come from, the train, the email addresses, telephone details, payment details, and of course I've got a list of the honorary life members. A lot of people don't seem to have email addresses. You didn't put it on right. A lot of people don't have email addresses, and it makes it very difficult for me to do an instant communication with. I tried doing a mass email to bring myself to attention of people that haven't paid their fees, etc. Some people have got their telephone details and some people are going for mobile phones. It's a bit expensive really if I try to contact you on mobile phones. So if you have got a phone that's a normal phone at home, I'd like that in detail rather than a mobile phone. Now this is an important triangle I see as part of my job. Membership secretary right at the top there, but I can't do my job without communicating between two other very important people. One being the treasurer, who takes the money for the membership, obviously, and the newsletter editor, who wants all the details, so he sends the newsletter to the right people at the right address. So we work as a triangle between each other to make it a successful.
He's an officer, and we've got a co-opted member, Dudley Springer, who's taken over from the last incumbent, Chris Baker.
Nice one to follow it.
You can't be technical.
For those of you that don't know me from out here, which is nearly all of you, I should imagine, I was co-opted onto the committee in July, so this will necessarily be a rather brief report. My name is Dudley Stringer. I'm a ex-41st Hereford supplier, same as Rod here. I'm aware that I'm very much a new boy, having only joined the association in 2010, and only now attending my first AGM. So I'm certainly starting out on what I believe they call a steep learning curve.
Sharper.
I have had several offers of help and advice from both past and present committee members whose experience I'm sure will be helpful. Since I took over the position, sales have been steady, but there again, I've nothing really to compare it with.
Right, afternoon, gents. As last year, you will not find a PowerPoint presentation from me anyway, because my report, like its author, bloody simple. It's a straight one-page report. For those who wish, the end of the table there, where I was sitting, there's a couple of hundred.
Rings all round.
Chuck him out.
There's copies of my report over there. However, before I start, I've got a couple of things just to mention before I present my report to you. First one is that one of our members here today and with us this weekend urgently requires a lift to Cosford tomorrow. So if anyone can oblige, the gentleman is right behind you.
That's not a gentleman.
What block are you in?
There we are. Once a boy, always a boy. We have no such thing as drop ones, only opportunities. Now the second thing is just to let you know that a certain little man who is celebrating his 88th. A second little man who celebrated his 88th birthday a few days ago sends his regards. Apologies, he can't be with us as we know, but Chief Behind just wants to be remembered to one another. Right, my report. I've put it into two again. First part is RAF Cosford, second part is here. As far as Cosford is concerned, I continue my weekly visits to Cosford, and I take great delight in enlightening and enriching the minds of those who don't really know too much about the boys and the training we did.
Apart from the calls and the emails that I've been getting about the website, I've also been getting a lot of emails and phone calls about things which are not really in my area of responsibility, but which I normally acknowledge and send them to the right person. But actually, all the contacts are on the back of the newsletter, you know, with the telephone numbers and email addresses. The minutes of this AGM, if anybody wants a copy of the full minutes, they're available on request from me on the seat of a sealed address envelope, stamped address envelope, sorry. It needs to be A4, and it needs to have a large stamp on it, because normally the AGM minutes run to 7 or 8 pages of A4. On the cenotaph, which has just been raised, last year we asked for 25 tickets, which we actually got. They were supplied through Bratz 192, who took the job of getting them from the British Legion. Unfortunately, they've now gone defunct. They've actually decided to close their association. And consequently, Alton apprentices have actually taken on the responsibility of getting the tickets from the British Legion. Now, being past experience with the Alton Apprentices admin secretary, I'm keeping my fingers crossed, but we have asked for 25 more this year. It will, as usual, be done on a first-come, first-served basis. If you want them, you can email me and tell me you want a ticket. I'll put your name on the list, but you won't get a ticket unless you send me a stamped address envelope. Okay? Last year, we had, I think, 15, 16 people who actually went to the cenotaph, so there were some spare tickets. I cannot guarantee there will be spare tickets this year, so it is definitely on a first-come, first-served basis. We've asked for, or we will be asking for 25 tickets next year, because next year is supposed to be a big year, because it's the start of World War I, Great War, and there are supposed to be different celebrations taking place at the same time. So if you want tickets for next year, I know it's a bit early, you might want to consider that as well. I have nothing else to say, basically. Just to once again, thank you very much for letting me do the job. And I look forward to seeing you at the dinner tonight. Thank you.
We've eventually planned. Thank you, all of you who replied to the questionnaire and the other pleas for information about what you would like done. As you've heard, it boils down to this, that we will have the enhanced Memorial Day next year. Cosford, Adam Sampson, the new station commander, It takes me back to Gary and Les, a few years station commanders back, really supportive, positive guy. So I'm very hopeful that, as he said, using the old phrase, subject to the exigencies of the service, we will have the whole nine yards, pipes and drums going all over the place, and it will be great. And for that reason, and I suppose to reciprocate a little bit, I would ask, and I was very grateful to see the hands go up of those that are going to go to their Battle of Britain service tomorrow. I think they would appreciate us being there. The numbers have been falling slightly, but the organisation has been in complete shambles over the last couple of years. Mm. Hopefully that will be repaired tomorrow, and the more of us that are there, the better. Thanks very much. We've heard about the services at St Clement Danes. It's a celebration service. As those that remember the ones that we did 10 years ago for the 10th anniversary, that was Coral Matins, which frankly just about blew me away. But So it's not Coral Matins. Tony will be sorting the service out with the chaplain, the resident chaplain, and it will be a service of celebration. And as he said, I think this is probably the last time we will host a service in St Clement Danes, the RAF Church. So the more of us that are there, the better. And it'll be a good weekend or a good day. Finally, I was interested in your comments about future reunions and that you didn't particularly want wives joining the party. So things will continue much as they are, but reviewed every year, as we've said before. We do listen to what people say. We do look at other locations and so forth, but I think all the feedback I get is that the large majority of people are very happy with the services provided here at Harper Adams. And so I don't see that changing much, but it will be kept, I promise you, under constant review. And the main thing is to keep the costs down so that as many people as possible can afford to come. I think that's enough for me. Thank you again for your support throughout the year, and enjoy the rest of the weekend. On to the next one.
Understand defence, which believe me is somewhat rare, but who themselves have served this country with pride. It is a genuine honour to be here this evening, so thank you.
Thank you. Because I'm famous, you see.
Hey, aren't it?
I know.
It's better than saying it's an alcoholic.
Oh, that's great. If you put your card on top of the pack, here we go. And what we'll do is cut the pack like that, so your card is somewhere in the middle of the pack. I'll just take the pen back because I'm so forgetful. I've got a mind like those things you strain vegetables with. What are they called?
Sieve,
that's it. Yeah, I've got a mind like a sieve. I can't remember what they're called. Anyway, what I need is a pound coin and some tissue paper. Oh, you've got a pound coin as well. Are you sure? Are you sure you can lend me a pound?
I'm working around 40 million tissue pockets.
All right, yeah, I know what you mean, yeah. Here we go. You've got a pound? A pound, yeah. Oh, that's great. That's great.
Is that a pound?
Yeah, so we've got a pound, and we'll wrap the pound up in the tissue paper like so, and we'll get the cards, and we'll put the tissue paper on the back of the cards like so, and can you flap? Can you flap like that? God! Look! We had to get a pound. It's just burnt through the cards. I can't believe that. It's gone right through all the cards. Unbelievable. It's gone right through all the cards. Actually, stop. It hasn't gone right through.
Where's my pound gone?
I don't know. Actually, if you take the top card, is that your card? Yeah? Oh, give him a big clap of thanks.
Thank you.
I don't know how that works.
Hey, you can get a job, you. I'm on the stage, you know.
I am, so I am.
Look at the screen on the stage. Look at that screen and keep looking.
to this evening's show, you are about to embark on an incredible journey to the center of your mind. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this evening's show. You are about to embark on an incredible journey to the center of your mind. You will witness unbelievable transformations and things that you have never seen before. Who knows? Perhaps you will be the star of this evening's show. Leave all of your preconceptions behind you.
It's going to be like working in Hollyoaks for me tonight. This is going to be so good. But I am a hypnotist as well, and what I do, I need lots and lots of people to come up on stage and be hypnotised, mesmerised, and circumstances permitting, we should have a good show. We're all going to do some mind reading, we're going to do some influence things. This is not magic. You're the stars of the show. I need lots and lots of people to come up here. And I know some of you have been hypnotised before. Some of you have gone down before. Some of you are very, very good at it. You've told me all about it. So what I'm going to do, I need lots and lots of volunteers to come up here. I need lots and lots of volunteers to fill up these chairs and take the show a little bit further. So please, 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 I'm going to play some music, and I do need lots and lots and lots of people to come up here. Come on, everybody, everybody can volunteer. Come on, everybody. I mean, at least about 12 people, where we go.
Come on.
I need a few people to help me out. I really need it. Seats. I do need lots and lots of people to help out. If I haven't got any volunteers, I'm afraid we're not going to have a show. So I do need a few more people. Here we go. That's right, I do need a few more people. Come on, let's get all these chairs filled up. Here we go. We are going to try and do some hypnosis, some mind reading, and some real magic. That's right, I need a few more people. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I need about three more. Three more, please. Here we go. Where's Dave? Where's Dave? Dave. Dave's been hypnotized before. I need lots of people to come up here. Here we go. Excellent. I need lots of people to help me out tonight. I really, really do. There we go. I've got about three chairs left. Three chairs. So I need three people to volunteer. I need about three more people. Three more people to come up here and help me out. That would be really, really helpful. Here we go. I just need a few more people. Three more people. Here we go. There we go, and then we can show you something fantastic. Excellent. There we go. Okay, that is great. Thank you very, very, very much for volunteering. Give these people a big loud crack and a big scream. In fact, can you all scream as loud as cat? 1, 2, 3. Excellent. Thank you so much for volunteering. Actually, can you unfold your arms? Can you unfold your arms for me? That would go. Yeah. No, no, if you can unfold your arms, that would be great. Because that makes me more approachable and more acceptable, doesn't it? No, no, don't defend yourself, that's all right. Has anybody been hypnotised before? Has anybody been under the influence before? You've been there, yes, you told me about it before, actually. So what we're going to do is a small experiment just to see who can take part in the show. And I need everybody in the room to take part. I need everybody to follow these instructions just to make sure that we're not missing anybody who can take part in the show. So I need everybody just to interlock the fingers, right? So can everybody interlock your fingers? Gentlemen, if you put your feet flat on the floor for me, and just interlock your fingers like so. And it's all about using your imagination, using your concentration. Don't talk to the people next to you. I need you to take this very, very, very seriously. If you just put your feet flat on the floor for me, put your feet flat on the floor. Take this very, very, very seriously. Everybody, interlock the fingers like so. Can everybody interlock the fingers like so? And what I want you to do is stare at one of your knuckles of your thumbs. Just stare at one of the knuckles of your thumbs. Just concentrate and stare at one of the knuckles of your thumbs. And I want you to use your imagination, use your concentration now, and just imagine, hands together. Don't worry if your hands start shaking. You're not in the shower or anything, so you should be all right. Okay, you squeeze those hands together as tightly as you possibly can. Just squeeze those hands together. Just imagine that your hands are sticking together. They're pulling together. They're getting tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. That's very good indeed. Just squeeze those hands together. Just tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. Those hands are sticking together. They're pulling together. They're getting tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. And every time I say the word tighter, stage. Can you come and join me on stage? You look like a great customer, actually. Just imagine those hands getting tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. Yeah, they're sticking together. They're pulling together. They're getting tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter.
And deeper,
the deeper you go, the better you feel, the deeper you go. Your hands are getting tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. Just drift down and sink down, deeper and deeper and deeper. Don't worry about it. Good job you weren't in the shower, but don't worry about it. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, just shake your hands apart. There we go. That is because your subconscious mind is stronger than your conscious mind. Here for me, can you sit on this chair here for me? Thank you very much indeed. There we go. Don't worry about it. Everything's perfectly all right. Actually, if you just leave your drinks for me, gentlemen, just leave your drinks, because I just want to try something else. And I'm just talking to this gentleman here. I'm going to just tap you on the shoulder now, and you're going to open your eyes, and you're going to be wide awake, and you're going to sit on the chair. 1, 2, 3, open your eyes, you're wide awake. That's good. Can you come over here for me? Just, are you all right? You're having a good time, aren't you? Don't worry, if you don't remember anything, you had a great time. That's great. If you go and sit there for me, then we're going to have you. If you just sit down, give them a big round of applause and a big clap and a big scream. Okay. We're just going to try something else, just to land down to the floor, to the ground. And on the other hand, I put some wonderful, wonderful, wonderful big red helium balloons, which is pulling that hand up towards the ceiling. So just imagine, on the hand that's facing the ceiling, is some big, heavy, 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 heavy library books, and it's pulling the hand down to the ground, where the other hand, tied around the fingers, pictures of some beautiful, beautiful blue red helium balloons, and that hand is rising up, higher and higher and higher and higher. It's just rising up, higher and higher and higher. Well, the other hand is getting so heavy, so really heavy. Just use your imagination and use your concentration now. Just imagine that hand getting higher and higher and higher and higher. Well, the other hand is getting heavier and 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 heavier. That's right, use your imagination, use your concentration, and just imagine that your hand is rising high. Let it out slowly and gradually. Now we can just have some quiet in the room for a few minutes. Each and every one of you, just take a deep breath in and let it out slowly and gradually. Just keep your eyes closed, everyone. Keep your eyes closed. Loose limb, lazy rag doll now. Your whole body like a loose limb, lazy rag doll. I want each and every one of you to imagine now, imagine that you're on the top of a flight of 10 steps. And 5, and 6, and now 7. Every step you take, sinking down 100 million times deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper down. Taking step 8 now, and now step 9. Every step you take, you sink 100 million times deeper. As you take step 10 now, you just drift down totally and completely and become totally, completely relaxed. And I'm going to come around each and every one of you and touch you very gently on the side of the neck. And as I do, you're going to go into a deep, deep state of relaxation. And each and every one of you just drift down deeper and deeper and deeper down. Deeper and deeper and deeper down. Just drift down deeper and deeper and deeper down. With every breath you take, with every word I say, with every note of our music. Each and every one of you, you're going to have an overwhelming compulsion, an irresistible desire to do everything I tell you to do. You will not do anything that embarrasses you in front of your friends or your family. Just nod your head if you understand. Nod your head if you understand. That's right, just nod your head if you understand. Nod your head if you understand. That's right, just nod your head if you understand. Do not do anything that will embarrass you or anybody, and do not do anything that is dangerous. Just nod your head if you understand. Nod your head if you understand. But you have an overwhelming desire, an irresistible compulsion to do everything I tell you to do. But you won't do anything that is embarrassing, and you won't do anything that you don't want to do. But you will have an overwhelming motorbike. Okay, get off the motorbike now. And now, it's so hot, that you might need a drink, a nice cold drink of milk, but there's a cow in front of you. The only way to get the drink is to actually, when I say, go deeper and deeper and down. You will remain on the chair, and you will not fall off this stage. You remain on the chair. I'm just talking to the gentleman, I'm touching on the shoulder now. 1, 2, 3, open your eyes, you're wide awake. Thank you very much, can you come and sit down here for me? Thank you very much, if you come and sit down here for me, and sit in front of everybody, that's great. What's your name?
It's
David, just sleep, go deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper down. I'm just talking to the gentleman touching on the shoulder now. 1, 2, 3, you're opening your eyes from wide awake. What's your name?
No,
can you come over here and sleep with everybody else? That is great. Thank you very much, Noel. That is great. If you just sit down there for a bit of typing, so you can keep your eyes closed, but if you reach your hands out to the computer, to the typewriter, can you reach your hands out like that? And what we need to do is type as fast as you can, because the boss is coming in, and we've got 1,000-word report to get in the next 10 minutes. So type as fast as you can. Keep on typing, 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 keep on typing. Type as fast as you can. Keep on typing, keep on typing, keep on typing, keep on typing. And the more you and the audience claps, the faster you type. Everybody clap, give them a big round of applause. Keep on typing, keep on typing, keep on typing, keep on typing. That is right. Keep on typing, keep on typing, keep on typing. That is brilliant. Keep on typing, keep on typing. Okay, each and every one of you can stop doing that now. The next bit is my steam engine bit, the steam engine. So each and every one of you, I'd like you to imagine that you're big, big steam engines. And as I put the microphone to your face and touch you gently on the shoulder, you're going to make a noise like it's a steam engine. Okay. Very, very good. Give him a big clap. As I touch you on the shoulder, you're going to make a noise like a steam engine. Very, 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 very good. As I touch you on the shoulder, you're going to make a noise like a steam engine. Ooh, very, very good. A bit gay, but very, very good. Give him a big clap and a big scream. Imagine that you are an amazing Japanese comedian from Japan. You are going to imagine that you are the funniest comedian ever in Japan, and you come over here to see your mates in the RAF and to give them some of your Japanese jokes. Don't worry if you can't speak Japanese, you just make Japanese up as you go along. So I want you to talk in Japanese, just making it up, and just pretend, just imagine that you are the best comedian in the whole of Japan. And the more the audience laughs, the funnier your jokes get. 1, 2, 3, open your eyes, you're wide awake. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a big hand, just come all the way from Tokyo. The amazing, brilliant, Japanese comedian.
That's all. I tell you a joke in Japanese.
I tell you what, sleep, just go deeper and deeper. Sleep. And 5. And when we get to 1, you're going to open your eyes, you're going to be wide awake, and you're going to be normal self in every way. As we get to step 5, step 4, step 3, step 2, and step 1. And as we come from 1 to 5, you're going to open your eyes, you're going to feel fantastic, you're going to be your normal self in every way, and everybody's going to give you a big round of applause and a big clap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you all open your eyes, these guys are going to give you a big clap and a big scream. I think the girls have got a drink for you. Thank you very much for volunteering. If you go and sit down, we're just going to try.